Okay. Whoa. Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Scorched Earth. This is a slightly different place than where I was last time. Last episode, I was on single player. We went ahead. The group, the crazy fellas, decided they liked this game enough to want to play it. So we've got a multiplayer server running, and I've built this little hut and with a little bit of Scriptor's help. And there is Scriptor, who is currently unconscious, standing up. I don't understand it, but that's okay. He started replacing the floor of this little hut with some adobe. Initially, we built it with thatch. We've got one bed down. We've got four people playing here, Praedox, Steppy, Scriptor, and myself. And, whoop, hello. Scriptor tamed this little gal, Pixie, that we've been using for food storage. What was that? Oh, it was poop. I saw a little meter, and it was poop meter. Apparently, she's pooped. Yeah, there she is. So we're using her for kind of food storage right now, just storing food. So I'm thinking of putting that meat there. And, you know, we got the real basics going here. We haven't done much. We just built this little hut just to save ourselves. The sandstorms came, and it was pretty crazy. I'm actually looking to build a wooden, because I think there's a couple raptors outside. So I'm going to look for a hatch. Have I learned that? I don't know that I have. Wood, hatch frame. There's a window frame. I do have the hatch frame and the ladder. That's what I'm looking for. Hatch frame and ladder. There's the hatch frame, and I need more wood. I don't have anywhere near enough. And thatch. Does he have any wood over here? Does he have any wood on himself? The reason I say, does he have it on him, is I don't want to go outside, because I do believe there's raptors out there. So we're going to go ahead and actually dump this stuff off and see if we can fight the raptors. I built a bow and have some arrows. So we have a little bit of defense here. Okay. The raptors were like right on the side of those rocks. And we built a tent. I think Scriptor did this. And the tents are really cool. They're just portable. They're like, okay, it's one of the herbivores. They're like sleeping bags in that you can pick them up. You can close them and open them like a door. And they act as a portable shelter. And that's really important. And you get insulation stats here for the protection from the heat and the cold. But also you get the sandstorms. And when the sandstorms come, and I hope one comes on video so we can show you, but it basically makes you move really slowly. It takes away all your stamina. And I think that's all it does. I don't think it necessarily hurts you in any other way. This thing over here, these bugs are awesome with the blue... The blue bellies, they are water jug bugs. You can drink water from them, walk up to them, drink water. They'll fly away for a little bit and then land, and then you can do it again. If you kill them, you can still drink the water from them before you harvest their chitin. But they're like the last thing you want to kill. You'll only kill them if you're desperate for chitin, because they will save your life. Speaking of water and saving our lives, I'm looking to build a water well. And it requires some cementing paste, which I acquired by, unfortunately, killing a couple of the water jug bugs and getting some chitin. But I'm going to need some stone fiber and all of that stuff. So I'm going to be building that here shortly. And I think the theory is that that stuff taps into some sort of water source. You can just put it on the ground and drink from it without having to be near a lake or anything. Speaking of, we're built right up here above this lake. The reason we're up here is it's mildly safe. Those raptors are the first things I've seen, actually, right over here in this general area. There's tons of bad things down there. So kind of just parked up here for now. Obviously, we're going to explore a ton more of this map. Where are we? We are over here. You see, we're at roughly kind of 65-ish, 60, somewhere in that range. And, like I said, right now I'm the only one on. The others are off doing other things, sleeping, because most of them are in other parts of the world. I believe Scriptor is in Germany, I think. And Praedox and Steppy are both in Australia. So it's just me. All right. I need to gather some more wood because I still want to build that hatch frame so I can get up on the roof from the inside in case something comes and attacks. So I'm going to come over here. And these things do give wood and also sap, which is really cool. I don't think you can, like, put a sap tap on them. They look too small for that. More water jug bugs over there. My eyes are out for those raptors because I don't think they're dead. Although the herbivore is still here, so it might have killed them, which would be good news. So let's grab the building materials again. The only mod we're running here right now is stacks, the stacks mod. So we can go over 100 on things, which is really handy. So we really appreciate that and enjoy that. We're a little nervous about putting any other mod on right now because Primitive Plus breaks when you put mods on that modify the Ingrams. And so we're nervous to do that. The stacks mod obviously doesn't. And speaking of Ingrams, as I showed you last time, this is really cool, this filter here. There's a bunch of Scorched Earth ones that we're going to play with. Adobe. A lot of Primitive Plus stuff is in here. Adobe, I noticed, things of that nature. Probably some of this will go into Primitive Plus, like the Adobe Staircase and Adobe Railing and things of that nature. There's whips, boomerangs. Those are really cool. They look cool. My gamma must be up really high right now. And we've been playing along, playing with a whole bunch of commands to get people into the tribe and things. So that's why you're seeing all of this and teleports and stuff, trying to get people into the tribe. But my gamma's a little better now. Okay. So if I go back over here real fast and I say, just show me this Scorched Earth stuff. What is this? I still can't read this. Clay and preserving salt. Preserves food. Okay, so that's like spark powder in a way. I wonder how it works. Clay, use it for building, probably for building the adobe, I would imagine. Boomerang, a ranged weapon. Does it come back? Oh, I'm gonna have to try that. And then the whip. Keep your foes at bay and keep your herd moving. Okay, but this is what we're really after right now, apart from the from this guy. In fact, do I have enough materials to make more walls? I need to expand this up to two walls high. I don't think I can make any wood ones, but thatch ones for sure. I mean, I don't think I can make enough wood ones. I can't even make enough thatch ones because I'm short on thatch, of course. Okay, well, we're going for one. All right, we'll go for one eye. This is just a starter hut, right? We'll fix it later. We'll fix it in post, as they say. All right, come on, give me a... There's a ladder. Perfect. All right, now we have a way of coming up here and surveying without coming out. Now, obviously, we're going to have to reinforce our structure or else it's going to be destroyed pretty quickly. But at least we could survey. That's pretty cool. All right, now, what do we need to make that water well? Let's see. Well, I'm going to need that cementing paste. That's fine. 50 stone, which I have. Oops, let's come on in here. Let's do this. Okay, come on. You can do this. You've been playing this game long enough. You know how to hit, what keys to hit. And I've been leveling up fortitude quite a bit because of the heat. And we do have the setting here on the server where water reduction is down to 50%, or water usage, because if you don't, you basically start dehydrating and running out of water every 30 seconds. It's just insane. So it's unplayable, basically. We needed to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and go for some more weight right now, because I'm going to kind of soon to be in a very building phase. What else do we need? Well... okay, we have the stone, the thatch. Obviously, I need more thatch, and then some flint. We've got the flint. So I need 30 thatch. I don't have 30 thatch on me, but I do have the flint. I don't remember how much it needed, but that's fine. Let me put the sap in here. Do I need fiber? Is that something in the well? I do, but I only need 20, and I only needed 10 flint. Okay, so coming over here. Let's get rid of all of this. In fact, let's just get 10 of that. All of that. I just need 30 of this. All right, now I need to go get some thatcheroonie. I'll walk out here after being careful, and all of a sudden there'll be a raptor right there just looking at me. That's my luck. That'll be what happens. Hello. What did I just say? There he is. I don't have a spyglass. I don't know his level. Should I engage? I don't know that there's a good rock to get up on that he won't get up on. Really have to take care of these raptors. I'm not in a position to tame at the moment. It would be nice to tame, though. Let me see if I can actually hit him. I did. Did he run? He is running. Chicken? Yeah, you better run. Where's his buddy about to eat my face? No, he's coming back. He's like, whoa, what was that? Oh, there you are. Oh, of course. I am... Calm down, Bowden. Calm down. You have fought many a raptor. Oh, that hit, you saw the blood? No hit marker, no damage indicator. I don't even think that gave me a damage indicator. That did. His tail. There we go. All right, at this point, I'm gonna get this guy with spear. And he's running. Come here, you coward. Come back here. Nice. Level 12. Perfect. What's in your inventory? It said I could check your inventory. Now I can't check your inventory. What's going on here? Well, I'm going to get some flint. And some sand, apparently. And some stone. I can't afford much more. Wait, I have to dump some of this stone. Wow. This rock has got a lot in it. Just so I can check your inventory. Back to the flint. Come on. Leveled up again. A lot of harvesting. All right. I can't move. That's fine. Sand is everywhere. I'm going to dump that. It's pretty heavy. I don't really think I need all of those rocks. So can I move? There we go. Nice. I like how they put useful things inside raptors. I mean, they're obviously, even in ARK Prime, you occasionally find useful things in every critter. But it's just nice to see there. And there's a different kind of bug. That's not a water bug. That could be an oil bug. They take the place of the trilobites, basically. What is this one? Yeah, oil jug bug. And if you come over here and you just grab his oil, I got 12 oil out of him. Look at that. Procroptodon. All right, let's head back to our base now that we have hopefully enough. Oh, look, yeah. Oh, man. What level are you, Doty? 28. All right. We may come back for you. In fact, let me bump my weight real fast. We may come back for you. See, I need to learn to stop sprinting so much. I'm a sprinter. I love sprinting. But that eats through water like crazy. And it makes for a longer trip. And there's a water jug bug up there, which is nice. But it saves the water. All right, speaking of the water, let us now see. Do I have what I need? All right, well. Did I type in well? No, I did not. The thatch, which is what I came for. Okay, yeah, that's great. And most of that, and most of that, and I need to go get the thatch now. Okay, I was heading over here, wasn't I, when I saw the raptor. And he did have a buddy, so need to keep an eye out. The water jug bug is here. I'm going to go ahead and grab a drink. Thank you, sir. All right, that should be enough thatch for my water well. All right. Now we get to experiment and see if this water well actually does what I think it does. We'll find out. Closed door. Really nervous in these early stages. This is a cool game because this DLC, because it reminds me of what ARK was like in the beginning. I don't know what all these critters are, what this world is like. I don't know what this map is like at all. I don't know what will and won't kill me. It's just really cool. I don't want a well over there. I want a well over here. All right. Cementing paste is all I need. Excellent. I've got that. 16 of them, even. I didn't even need 16. Well. All right. It says, this stone tap allows access to the water in an irrigation network. Now, it might just be a tap that you have to supply water to, right? Can refill containers, irrigate crop lots, or provide a refreshing drink. It's a tap. But they do have a stone tap in here as well already. There's a stone tap, right? So I'm hoping that it will actually, because I've run across these in the wild. I don't think I've caught one on camera. Thanks for pooping in here. Who was that who pooped? Was that me or was that you? That was you. I don't think I've caught one on camera, but they exist. Let me put this meat in here for you. Give you some weight. In the wild, and you can drink from them. They're just sitting there on the ground. Sometimes you come up on them, and you can definitely. Oh, you need a water vein. Okay. Does that mean I need to run pipes up? Or does that mean I need to find another one of those water wells, or I need to put it near water? If I put it near water, what's the point? There is water down there. And I could theoretically run some water up here. I've never seen it rain here, ever. It doesn't mean it doesn't. Just haven't seen it do it. So the rain might be an issue. All right, we need to figure out this water thing. Or I just wasted all those cool resources. Well, this is Doty Central here, 28. They all look, they're all tan, 16. I've been looking for these water things. This is what I was talking about. It's a water vein. Now, the description of that well, let's go get that well. We're not that far from our base. Our base is right over here, our little hut. Shouldn't call it our base. There it is. Because I don't know if this is where we're going to build permanently. This is just where we're kind of setting up for now. Just to have a place to go and crash and everything and experiment. And, yeah. So the well that I built is here. And what does it say again? Stone tap access to the water in an irrigation network can refill an irrigation pause or provide. So I'm wondering if it's got something to do with that. Might as well not use that right now. I've been upgrading the building. I went to two stories, mostly wood, with a foundation of adobe. And I need to do one more adobe foundation to finish that off. Over here where that guy was. There it is. There's the water vein. Now I'm wondering if you could like snap it to this. Is this what you do? Let's see. Oh, whoa. Heck yeah. It wants to snap like crazy. Okay. Whoa. The water vein went away. And now it says it's irrigated. I can drink from it. So it's actually like a water reservoir as well. But that's kind of weird. Because what I had before was a natural tap. And now I have a reservoir that I guess it's being filled from the ground. But that's pretty cool. And it said it's part of an irrigation system. So, of course, now I'm wondering. Stones. Let's hammer some rocks here and get some stones. Make some stone pipes. Some sand. Sand will be used to make the clay, which is used to make the adobe. So that's pretty cool. So, pipes. Let's make a straight pipe. And stick that right down in here. Okay. Now, can I connect a pipe to it? Are you that same Dodi I saw before? Yeah, I think you're one of them. Hey, Woody, what are you? You're always level one. They're always level one. Oh, yeah, you can snap pipes to it. In one of two direct... Three? This way, too? Nope, just three directions. Okay, so you can do... This is kind of like a natural little water source. There's no water underneath. Using the K mode to look underneath the world. So could I run pipes all the way over to our base? I mean, it'll look kind of tacky, but... Let's do it so we can have some water over there. Looks like we might have to do some inclines pretty soon. So let me make some pipes and run this thing over there and see if I can get it home. Hey, thanks, Mott, man. 28. All right. Not ready to tame you yet. All right. You know how I said I didn't see it raining? It never rained? It's raining. It must be extremely rare. But it just decided to rain. Cool. All right, I'm making some clay here. I just want to show you this. And should be enough, I think, to make the last adobe foundation for this house, which also requires some wood thatch and fiber. Let's see what kind of wood thatch and fiber situation we have here. Wood thatch and fiber. Do we have enough for that adobe foundation? We sure do. Put this stuff back. Go ahead and put the clay in there too, I guess. And use it right there. Perfect. Oh, wow. The little blanket or whatever for the mortar and pestle blends right in. That's beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, so I've run the pipes all the way to the house. Trying to figure out the right way for entry into the house is becoming kind of an issue because it doesn't quite line up right. I've got a tap outside here. And I've got this that's hitting the foundation. And my real question, and the reason I just went out and got some wood, was what would happen if I was to put a tap down here? Could we access it? My hunch is no. Oh, you can. Oh, my goodness, you can. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. Drink water. And you can put your stuff in it. That's perfect. Oh, I love it. And we've got some outside as well, so we can put some farming out there if we really wanted to. And people running up can get a drink. So, excellent. So, wouldn't you know it? I came out here to tame one of those big trolley trike kind of guys, and they're all gone. There was one out here, even around the house, and now it's gone. It must have fallen off into the canyon, I imagine. Probably didn't despawn. Anyway, I wanted to do that because I wanted to make even more narcotics, because we have plenty of spoiled meat now, but not enough narco berries. I'm going to have to gather them by hand, I guess, for now. I checked out that yellow drop that you just saw there. I'm not high enough level yet. I need to be 55. I am only 43. However, I did discover a couple things that they've changed in the game. One is this. My HUD? There's my HUD. One is this, up at the top. You know, it's always said the time. It's always said how many days the server's been up. It always says where you were and the temperature. But now, what does it say? 65 degrees west. I think it's telling you compass directions. I don't. Now I'm not sure. I thought it was telling me which direction I'm pointed. But I don't know what 65 degrees west means. Bring up the map. 65 degrees west. Well, it's not going to be 65 degrees of longitude, is it? Because I think I'm at around 60. Huh. 65 degrees west. Yeah, weird. I don't know what that means, but it's new, so be curious to find that out. Well, if I can't tame one of those big guys, I want to tame something. Can these guys be tamed? I don't think they can. I think the whole point is that they can't be tamed. They just roam around. You can't tame your own water jug, I guess. We should probably try at some point. And we will. There were some doties here just a second ago. Wouldn't mind having a dotie, although... There we go. Right behind me. What level are you, buddy? That's the level 28. Probably the one we've been seeing all along. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I really want to tame a dotie until I'm ready to build somewhere. So, darn it. I really wish those big guys were here, those trike-like guys. I really wanted one for getting some berries. Doties are not very good for that. Ankies are okay, but you really want the trike kind of guys. I'm figuring these guys are like trikes. So I'm hoping they'd be good at getting the berries. Okay. Nope, no more. Is that one of them over there stuck on a tree? Oh, it sure is. He might work. Hey, buddy. Before I get you, I need to get these cactus things too so we can make more clay. Nice. What level are you? Oh, you're only level 4, but you know what? You can get some berries. Whoop, I should probably change that to narcotic arrows, wouldn't you think? And I want to put my backup bow there and have it set for narcotics. There we go. Oops. Okay. And shot one. Two. Oh, and it got free. Three. They're pretty passive. Level four. Shouldn't it go down by now? Oh, that didn't do anything. It's not a trike, because trikes would turn and fight. There it goes. Whoa. Water? Oh, these things contain water. Oh, that's awesome. They're like a camel. That's what they are. I don't know why I didn't come prepared with any I have plenty of narcotics. Any berries? Hello? Berries, please. I hate when it's hard to get the berries from the bush because there's rocks nearby. Oh, boy. Any berries now? Any more berries? There we go. Oh, there's some berries. Oh, his torpor's not dropping very fast at all. Or her, for that matter. Only level four, so it's not the end of the world. Female level four. That's cool, though. Wow, I didn't even know that. Can you get it naturally? I don't think you can get it naturally by walking up to them. Oh, it's taming really fast. This is a Morellatops. What's the saddle? Morellatops. There it is. I've already learned it. Now I'd figure out how to make it. It's in hand, it looks like. Morellatops. There it is. I just need to get some wood, and I can make one right now. There's some wood right here. All right. Morellatops. Awesome. I'm giving myself fortitude now because I've been getting heat stroke. I don't like it. Okay. She should be tamed up any second. Well, this is cool. You can just drink water from it. It's a reservoir. You know, it's a water reservoir. So I guess when it rains, or can you refill them yourself? Do you have to put water in there to refill them? Huh. 99% plus one level should be level 5. Level 5 awesome Morellatops. Come on, tame up. I want to see what kind of berry getting you do. If you even do it. So it's not a trike. It's a completely new kind. I mean, it's a trike in the sense that it's big, lumbering herbivore that wanders around commonly, which is kind of what a trike is, right? Well, big meaning, you know, medium size, I guess. So it fills that role, but it doesn't have any of the functions of a trike. I'm just hoping it can harvest, and its only benefit isn't the water. Please harvest berries. But even if it's just the water, that's pretty cool, too. You can travel with her. Assuming you can defend her, or she can defend herself. And drink from her, which is really nice. And I don't know what the weight is. Let's look at the stats. Oh, there she is. Oh. You know what? I'm not going to claim her for mine. I'm going to just say, use me for now. Because I might claim another one later. We'll call her Tanker. She's a water tank. So she's a tanker. Okay. What is your weight? Your weight is 4. That's pretty good weight. Pretty good weight. The rest of this I'm going to go put back in the chest, so. Okay. That's her normal speed. Here's her sprint. Stamina drains pretty darn fast, just like a trike. Okay. It's kind of getting dark. I'll gamma up a little bit for you guys. Go gamma 3 for the moment. She just had her first poop. All right. Come on over here. Main attack, yes. Yes. She has trike abilities. Nice. Let's collect a whole bunch of narco and make some more narcotics. And guys, I think that's pretty much going to do it for this episode. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.